Carousels are one of my favorite social media content types to create, not just because they still perform well and get great engagement, but because I love that you can take your audience on a guided journey through a story, take them step by step through educational content. You can build intrigue that leads to a big reveal, and you can even create before and after transitions just with a swipe. And of course, you can use them on Instagram, Blue Sky, YouTube, Facebook, even LinkedIn. But if you want to keep them interesting and really capture your audience's attention, it helps to keep an eye on what's working right now. So today I'm going to walk you through 5 carousel design trends and show you how to put your own twist on them just in Canva. This trend mixes cutouts, stickers, torn edges, and layered elements. It's always interesting to combine something that feels really inherently analog and tactile with a digital medium. Plus, it's a really highly customizable style and technique that you can make work for your brand. And of course, it adds depth to your design. Now in Canva, there are a few ways to create these kinds of elements. First of all, you can grab existing sticker elements in the Canva Elements library by just searching for stickers and maybe a theme, or cutouts and a topic. There are also cutout images in the photo library, and you can grab them just by filtering by cutout. You can also grab elements from existing photos or uploaded photos. Just click on the image, go to Edit and Magic Grab, and then you can choose the element you want to extract from that image. Once you've done that, just click on the grabbed element. And to add this very popular white outline effect you see everywhere at the moment, you can just go to Edit again and then use the Shadow tool to add an outline. Lastly, there is a really cute little Canva app called Choppy Crop that allows you to draw around anything in a photograph, and it creates an isolated element of your selection. Then again, you can add that outline, or maybe apply something like a screen effect or something similar to create a magazine cutout feel from your own custom selection of any image. Now, one caveat I would give is this look has already become a little overused for me. So make sure you put your own stamp or brand style on it, whether that's through adding brutalist style elements or unique brand colors or lots of interesting stickers, or even creating a more retro vibe with this. Experiment to find what works for you and your brand. Another trend that is all about adding an analog and human touch to your carousel design is the use of handwritten text. Now, handwriting adds a personal feel immediately, and it makes designs feel more warm and authentic. I love that it feels like a real human has left their mark on this digital creation. And this can be created in Canva in a few ways. First of all, Canva has quite an extensive list of great fonts that already look like handwriting. Just remember when choosing that legibility should always be the priority. Another trending effect is to curve text around objects within images, as if they've been drawn on. And this can be achieved in Canva by using the curve tool in the text effects. It can be a little bit fiddly, but if you break the text into small chunks and then use the sliders to create the curve you want, it works really well. Lastly, you can use your own handwriting. Of course, you could do this digitally if you use an iPad or if you can write on your phone without it looking a mess, which I can't. But you can also just write on a piece of paper. Take a photo of that, upload it to Canva, remove the background, and then you can edit that isolated text element and use things like duotone to match the brand colors, for example. It's really powerfully effective. There's actually a lot you can do using handwriting and hand-drawn elements. So please let me know in the comments if that's something that you would like some more tutorials about, and that way I know to create those. We've all seen screenshots of comments or testimonials used in carousels and posts, and that's because social proof is essential and it still works really well. But a fresh take that is trending at the moment is using screenshots from your own notes or to-do app on your phone. It gives that over-the-shoulder, behind-the-scenes feel, and it just feels really authentic and real. Plus, if you want to take it further, screen record your phone or even your computer screen if that's easier for you as you type out a note or a list. Then just upload that recorded clip into Canva and insert it into your carousel. It's a great scroll stopper, and immediately it makes people really interested in seeing where it's going and what's being typed. And if, like me, your typing really sucks and you make lots of typos, even better, because it reinforces that it's a human typing, which only adds to that feeling of authenticity. Now, just a heads up with this kind of thing is if you're using a screen recording or any motion on an Instagram slide or a carousel slide, remember to export that slide as a video, even if the rest are images. And most platforms allow mixing images and videos in a single carousel. As you probably know, I'm a big fan of simplicity. And our last two design trends use very simple but effective techniques to communicate your message. But before we get into those, if you found this helpful and you would like more tutorials, inspiration, and free resources to create better design for better business impact using Canva, if you head to the link that's on the screen right now or in the description below the video, you can join over 7,000 amazing people who receive my free weekly design digest called Meaningful Creations. I really love writing it, and it would mean a lot to me to be able to share with you every single week through that newsletter. Recently, I've seen a lot of really high-performing carousels using a very simple approach. Just bold, sans-serif text over a simple image or B-roll. It's really powerful. It shows a real confidence in your written content, and it really grabs attention. Now, there are a few key things to making this work well. First of all, keep the text short so that you really maximize visual impact, and then make use of the further carousel slides to build the message. And since text is the star in this kind of example, a nice thing is that your background visuals don't have to be perfect, but I think they should still be relevant. And I know this is where I'm going to upset a lot of social media people making money off showing you how to record 100 reels in 5 minutes. But I would encourage you to at least try and make the image or B-roll relevant to the content or to your brand. It just adds more authenticity and reinforces the message. I know it's all about making it easy, but I still want to feel like someone, including me, has made an effort when creating this content to make it work together. Also, a pro tip to take this whole idea up a notch, break your text into separate text boxes for each line. Then you can manipulate those individually. So you could add a shadow effect for added depth as you overlay and play with sizing of the individual lines. Our final trend we're going to look at is one that is, again, so simple to execute, but so impactful. A lot of creators are getting huge reach, especially shares, with carousels that are just plain text on a single color background. This kind of breaks the usual flow of images in your feed, and the trend works even better when you use consistent brand colors and fonts. So make sure you have those set up in your Canva brand kit or in your own brand cheat sheet. We actually cover this inside my Canva OS course. You can just create your own brand style guide with color and font and element references, and then you can star that, so it's easily available for you to refer to anytime you need it. Consistency is so important in building a recognizable and memorable brand, so don't sleep on creating that brand guide. And if you're posting a quote or a single statement, you could actually repeat the exact same content across multiple slides, just with different background colors. This increases the chance of you appearing in somebody's feed, and it also makes it more shareable because people can pick a color that suits their own brand aesthetic. These trends are all about adding fresh energy to an already effective content format. And if you found these helpful, please let me know in the comments so I can create more content like this for you. Thank you for being here, folks. I so appreciate you. I wanted to leave you with a quote that keeps popping to my mind at the moment for obvious reasons. I couldn't find the original credit, but the quote is, "When you have more than you need, build a longer table, not a higher fence." That's it, folks. Stay kind, keep creating, and I'll see you next week.